Hello, everybody. Welcome to WineUpTV. I am your host, Wayne, and when we come back, we're going to go to Four Graces Winery. We're actually in one of their vineyards right here at the foot of the Dundee Hills in Dundee, Oregon, in the northern Willamette Valley. Stay tuned. We're going to have five great wines, Pinot Blanc, Pinot Gris, and three Pinot Noirs. I'll see you in a second. Hello, everybody. Welcome back to WineUpTV. I am Wayne, and I'm here with Jason Sr., the tasting room...
Direct sales manager.
Here at Four Graces Winery in the Willamette Valley. And this is a winery that I like to frequent. They have great wines. It's a great story. It's a great program. And Jason, please, spend a couple of minutes. Tell me about the Black family and the owners of Four Graces.
Well, yeah, the Four Graces, it's owned by Stephen Paula Black. They live in Rancho Santa Fe in San Diego, and they've got four daughters and one son. And if you even look on the bottles, you can see the girls' names here on our foils of our bottles. It's Juliana, Alexis, Vanessa, Christiana, and then don't forget Nicholas, the son. He's the keeper of the Four Graces, and he can be found on the reserve bottle. So, so there's four daughters and one son. We have two vineyards. One vineyard here. This is the Black family estate where the tasting room is situated, and that's in the Dundee Hills. And then we have another vineyard in Carlton, and that's a very unique vineyard in that it's biodynamic and sustainable. So
sure.
We're very good to the earth. So.
We try it. We try our best.
Yeah, we try our best. Yeah,
absolutely. Especially if you're in Oregon, everybody's got to be, you know, LEED certified, salmon safe, and all this stuff. So we try to do whatever we can to give back to the nature, I guess, yeah. So to speak. Lack of better words. Anyway, the wines here. So you do Pinot Gris, Pinot Blanc, three different Pinot Noirs. Amazing little vineyard right here. How many acres is this one?
It's around about just over 50 on the vine.
Okay.
And then when you look at exterior-wise, if it was for the surrounding areas, it's 90 acres. And then the Carlton Vineyard is around about just over 40 acres under vine.
And this is all state fruit, correct?
Everything you're tasting is grown by us. So, and we'd actually, the interesting thing with us is we have, as I said, we have two sites, two vineyard designated wines, and we do a Black family estate and a Doe Ridge. So we actually do six wines all alike.
Okay.
Two single block wines.
So. Excellent. Well, let's get started here. Let's start with your Pinot Blanc. Or Pinot Noir.
You'll get the Gris first.
I will do the Gris first.
Okay, so here's the Gris.
All right, excellent.
And
tell us about the 09 vintage a little bit, you know, how this kind of made.
09, if you think back, it's only a year ago. It was a much warmer vintage for this area, and the crop levels were much higher than previous vintages, like 08.
I remember that, man. The clusters looked like they were on steroids.
Yeah, it was huge. I couldn't believe it. I was away on vacation. I came back. And the vineyard, the fruit was just huge. So with our Pinot Gris, if you smell on the nose, it's really got that honeysuckle on it.
Very nice.
Really citrusy there. And a bit of Granny Smith apples I tend to find. Great summer wine and great with seafood and crabs and oysters.
Very nice. Let's give this a little taste.
And actually, the Gris is grown on the estate where we are here today. And most of these wines you'll taste, except for the Willamette Valley, which is a blend of the two vineyards. Everything else is right behind us here at the Black family estate.
Very nice. Now, it's a nice effort. Reasonably priced wines as well. What's the retail on this?
$18 a bottle.
$18 a bottle.
So it's a great price. I always get excited about our Pinot Cream, Pinot Blanc. It's pretty great wines.
Yeah, very nice.
And we always get positive feedback from our guests in the tasting room. And great summer wines.
Excellent. All right, let's move on. Let's do the Pinot Blanc. Let's just slug it down, mate, huh?
Okay, so here's a report of some of that. So this is the Pinot Blanc. And the Blanc is real tropical fruit bowl. You know, there's not many wineries in the area that do a Pinot Blanc. It's a bit of a pity because I tend to find Oregon Pinot Blanc is really starting to catch on.
Absolutely.
You know, I could only think of probably 9 to 12 producers, I think.
If that. That would be a little long. High. It's one of my favorite Oregon white wines. You know, of course, you have Chardonnay planted up here, a lot of Pinot Gris, little Riesling, little Gewürztraminer, some Mühlener, some Mühlener Thurgau.
Mm.
But the Pinot Blanc, yeah, there's only a handful of people that I know that make a Pinot Blanc, and they do it well. And like you said, it's very topical. You're going to get those different, like a mango, pineapple, just different.
Yeah, different wine altogether to like a Chardonnay. It's a good alternative to, say, Chardonnay and even Pinot Gris. So, just something people may not know about, Gris means French, in French, gray. So the fruit is a gray color, washed out, whereas Pinot Blanc is white. So that's where they get the word Blanc and Gris from.
Yeah, if you ever see a cluster of grapes, matter of fact, this fall, as harvest is going on, come out and shoot on the show, obviously, at a winery during harvest time. But on the Pinot Gris grapes, they're kind of like, almost like a red flaming color, you know, you buy at the grocery store. But they're all different, and depends on how much sun is, a little washed out, depends on how much sun is actually getting on the cluster themselves, you're going to get different degrees of color. So I was always wondering, why don't they make a pink Pinot Gris?
Well, there are some wineries that do that, and they just leave it on the skins for a bit longer.
Yeah.
Actually, one day I looked at a Pinot Gris, and I could actually see the pink tinge through it. I thought, wow, you know, it's a lot of people think of Gris as white, but it's actually a gray blush washed out color.
Sure.
So you could really make a rosé out of it. You know, Gris.
But you could. No, you could. And I'm surprised that nobody's done that.
Yeah.
Note to a winemaker. Somebody, please. Make a pink Pinot Gris.
Yeah.
Pinot Blanc, excuse me. And Pinot Gris.
Yeah.
Very nice, though. And this is pretty limited, isn't it?
Yeah, the ranges from, say, the OA vintage, which was much smaller, like a lot of wineries, we only did 600 cases of Pinot Blanc in 08, and this year we've done about 1,600.
Okay.
It's a bigger
vintage. And how many cases on the Gris?
Oh, hovers and then about, 1,400 to 2,000 cases.
Okay, a little bit more. You know, I tell you, as you're building your brand and you're building a fan base, they have a great wine club too, by the way.
Yeah.
But as they're building all the stuff up, you know, they start making a little bit more wine, some more of the vineyards come on track, and very nice, though. Good effort.
Yeah, so now we're going to go into what everyone comes out to Dundee Hills for, and that's the Willamette Valley Pinot. So it's a blend of the two vineyard designated wines. We've got Dundee Hills and our Yamhill Carl.
Pretty good at pouring on bottles.
Yeah, good. Comes with practice.
I tell you, man. Yeah.
Freaking Saturdays and Sundays in the tasting room, you're dodging weave anything you can. So this is a bit of a fun one. This is the 08 vintage.
And this is your first 08
vintage. It was 08. It was released the week before Memorial Day. You know, everyone's raving about the 08 vintage. It's one of the, everyone's saying it's one of the best vintages on record. Mind you, the 07s are looking pretty good at the moment.
They're finally coming around in the bottle. Yeah. You know, boy, I tell you, when the 07s were released last year, they were really tight. They were very, I hate to say Burgundy because it's very Oregonian in style, for lack of better words. And it was a cooler vintage. It did rain a little bit during vintage of the 2007. But I tell you, some of the samples I've had, I've actually done a couple of shows with 07s, they're phenomenal wines. They are. A couple of critics just blasted the vintage. I think it's a very elegant, very, very racy vintage. Good acidity in the 07s. 08, though, let's talk about this 08 for a second. Amazing little wine.
Yeah, so we said earlier on, 08 was a warm fall.
Beautiful.
You know, it's 2 years ago. I'm trying to forget about this, but it was warm right up to Halloween. So it was a really freaking vintage for Oregon. It was one of the warmer vintages towards the end of fall. So it produced some really exceptional wines. Most vineyards around this area, smaller yields, and I suppose that's the payoff. You can have a great vintage, but not a lot of it. So,
yeah, absolutely. So that's both the 09.
Yeah,
again, 09. Remember,
monster.
The Pinot clusters look like they were Zinfandel clusters.
Yeah,
huge. I've never seen Pinot get so big.
Yeah.
But again, you know, 09 is going to be very plush, like the 06s. But let's stay on this 08. This is a very nice
elegant. Yeah, real elegant. You know, it's got that real dry Dundee Hills dry fruit to it.
A little dusty.
Yammy or calm. So you got a little bit dusty, earthy characteristics.
Real earthy.
From that Doe Ritz, right? And then the Carlton Vineyard, you get that dried fruit and you know, a little bit of violets in there too. So, and it's from the Jory soils, of course.
Very nice. That's a nice wine.
Yeah, it's a great, it'll get better with age.
Yeah, this you know, the 08, another thing with the 08, you know, because it was such an extended hang time and it was like half the normal crop they usually get. In 2008, you have complete phenolic ripeness. In other words, the seeds, the skins, and all the juice are ripening up at the same time, which didn't quite happen. That's why you're going to get the plushier, meatier flavors of the 09s and like the 06s as well. But very, very interesting on this.
Yeah. So this is great. Love it. Oh, and it'll get better, as I said, with age. So.
All right. So let's
go on to the... Now, we're going from two vineyards to a single vineyard from here, from the Black Family Vineyard. And that's three of the most consistent blocks from right behind us. So we've got two clones in here. And that's even makes Pinot even more interesting is there's so many clones out there.
Yeah, there are a lot of clones. And what do you guys, I know up front here you have some clones, 113, 114, some Pommard clones, some Vaudeville clone.
Yeah, lots of them. Yeah, there's this one here, this is a Waitensville and a little bit of Pommard. So, or mainly Pommard and a little bit of Waitensville. So it's three blocks from this site. It tends to be the most consistent blocks from right behind us. And we're using 60% new oak compared to 30%.
Yeah, you can really smell the oak. You're actually, I know, on the 07 vintage, you've really pushed it.
And you talk about that Burgundian characteristic. Definitely can smell it in the 07 reserve.
Absolutely.
You know, it's that real forest floor, mushroomy.
Then you get a little bit of tar on it. Yeah, it's just different. It's very earthy.
You know, it's just, as I said, the 07s are coming around, they're becoming really aging with grace.
Yeah. Good acid, too.
Yeah.
Makes you pucker up. Very nice effort. And this one here, this was the Dundee Hills 2007. Pinot Noir.
Yeah.
Hey, look, we have people coming in.
Yeah.
It's great.
Hello. Are we catching with that time?
Every time's a good time. We're just on the end of shooting a show. Line up TV, but give us a couple seconds, we'll be done.
Absolutely.
Thank you. Yeah. So this is a very lovely wine. Very lovely. And the case production on this one?
It offered about 800 cases, which is 1,600. Comes in six pack. So yeah, and then the last one we're going to do, it's the limited stuff that you'll mainly get in the tasting room.
All right.
And the wine club. This is the Black Family Estate. So this is a single block from this site here. So we've gone from two vineyards, a single vineyard, and then finally a single block. So
within a vineyard.
Yeah, within a vineyard. So we do two of these single block wines. We do the Doe Ridge, and we also, which is sold out now, and the Black Family Estate. So these are very small in case production. Yet again, Waitensville clone. It's about 50% new oak, kept in oak for 15 months.
So, a little bit longer.
Yeah. This is one you
real panic.
Yeah. I tend to find always with the Black Family, it's been to find a little bit of licorice in there. And this one, boy, this one can sell it for... a bit longer. You're talking 3 to 5, 5 to 7, you know, 7 and a little bit more years.
Sure.
On the side.
That's my, you know, for Oregon Pinot, I think 6-7 years is max.
Yeah.
It really starts losing a lot of fruit after that time. I don't care who's producing it. My personally, just my taste buds as well. All right. So very nice wine. Just elegant.
Yeah, elegant.
A lot of tannins. A lot of acid in this wine. It's going to age really well.
It's great.
Tell us about your wine club.
Yeah, the wine club, with our wine club, you get all these wines shipped to you over 5 shipments. It works out to be a case a year. Great thing about the wine club is for locals, 15% off single bottles, 20% on cases. Every time you're here, we do a lot of events. We've got a fun event coming up this Saturday, which is the cupcake event. So after hours, between 5 and 7, club members can come in, pick up their shipment. And also taste our 5 wines with the 5 cupcakes. The other fun thing is, tasting rooms open 7 days a week.
There you go.
From 10 o'clock to 5.
10 to 5. Seven, so, we're right here on Highway 99. Yeah. This is like right in the hub of wine country right here.
And, you know, every now and then we might pull something out, like an old wine or, you know, say with our events, we'd love to pull out some things over Memorial Day and Thanksgiving as well.
Excellent.
So we do a lot of events throughout the year. But, if you like our, you may want to come and visit us, go through the wines, and you may want to look at the wine club because it is a really good wine.
Sure. Jason, cheers.
Cheers, mate. Have a good one.
Gotta like this North Portland accent right here, right from North Portland, not Australia, right here. WineUpTV, folks, when we come back, we're going to go to another winery, and I will tell you where that's at in a while. Cheers, everybody.